Oh my god, oh my god, it's a zombie! It's a zombie! No, don't eat me!
That was like.
Welcome to Zombieland.
Time to nut up or shut up.
This is
The Hardcast.
It's time for another apocalyptically undead episode of The Hardcast. I'm joined by Spanish.
Do you feel lucky, punk?
And Chris.
For whom the bell tolls.
Tonight's review slash discussion is about the zombie horror comedy Zombieland, directed by Ruben Fleischer, starring Woody Harrelson, Emma Stone, and a wannabe Michael Cera lookalike. When the world is overrun by zombies, a wuss and a badass have to team up with a pair of stuck-up bitches where they must survive their own unique methods to overcome the zombie horde, as well as survive each other. So Chris, do you feel prepared to survive the zombie holocaust? Or did your irritable bowel syndrome cause you to get eaten by a zombie?
Oh, I think I'm ready to survive. This movie and every other zombie movie before it has prepared me to survive the zombie holocaust. The thing that stuck out for me in the very beginning was the opening credits. I really liked the way they did the opening credits. Everything slow motion, and they got the For Whom the Bell Tolls song playing from Metallica.
Hell yeah, it was a perfect match.
It worked really well. As soon as I heard the song, I was like, oh, this is going to be good. Even my brother was watching with me. Actually, he wanted to be on this podcast, but he's actually working out some kinks on the website right now. My brother actually mentioned that when we were watching the opening, if the movie was going to be 3D, because the way they filmed the opening sequence in slow motion, and it was always liquids and blood and guts flying through the air, and it really gave off that 3D look, especially on Blu-ray.
There was always some type of liquid or blood or something like gushing out of somewhere.
Or like a bag full of money flying in the air or something.
Yeah.
A lot of people seem to like the businessman with an AK-47 shooting everything.
Like, I also like the strip club one too. That was a funny one.
That was disgusting. My brother was eating and he was not happy. Zombie strippers with their decaying tits hanging out. That's disgusting. We start out with the character of Columbus, I guess is what he's mostly referred to in the movie.
Yeah, I don't think they ever say his real name.
I think the only person's name they actually mention is the girl's name at the end, right?
Yeah, which I already forgot.
Starts out with him, and he's basically talking about his rules, the rules of survival, why he's still alive. There's a lot of really fun rules, and I like the way they set him up. What was the first rule they talked about? It was cardio.
The first rule is, cardio.
You need to be able to run away from the zombie if you want to stay alive.
He mentions how the fat asses get eaten first.
Yes.
Next rule was beware of bathrooms, or was it the seatbelt one?
It was the seatbelt.
That was pretty funny, too, because they were showing a clip of a lady escaping in her minivan.
Then she crashes and flies to the window.
The next rule would have been beware of bathrooms.
Let me back up. Second rule was actually double tap.
Oh, yeah. Double tap was a good one. Make sure you shoot them twice or in the head. Although they don't really make a big deal about shooting them in the head in this movie.
Yeah.
I guess supposed to just go with it.
Implied.
They're basically just saying make sure it's dead. They illustrate all the rules with the reasons why you should follow these rules with like a little clip. So I like that.
Yeah, those are pretty cool. Fourth one is the one where you don't go into bathrooms. And then third one was seatbelt.
Well, it wasn't don't go in the bathroom, just beware of bathrooms. So he was basically saying that
Right.
Whenever you feel the most safe is when you tend to get bitten. And then they showed a clip of a gas station attendant who you see later on in the movie, and he's taking a shit, and then he gets attacked in the bathroom.
Yeah, and you're definitely wondering how the hell he survived, because he's just some like scrawny, he's like the least likeliest guy to survive a type of zombie holocaust.
Yeah, and I didn't actually like his double barrel shotgun that much. It's cool because it's got the power, but you only got two shots.
Yeah, it sucks.
Even though they kept getting more guns throughout the movie, he kept sticking with the double barrel. And he was pretty lame walking around with his tote bag everywhere.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, God.
The rules were good, though. At least he thought them out. And he wrote them all down whenever he got new ones. He actually had a lot of rules. I don't think he went through all of them, actually.
No, the one thing I kind of wish they did was they would go more in-depth with the rules. Because, they used it along the beginning, that one time with the scene, and then kind of forgot about it, and then he brought it up.
Another thing I didn't like either was he didn't really bring up the rules with the other people in the movie. He would kind of hint at it, like, hey, you want to put your seatbelt on, or why don't you wear your seatbelt? Mm-hmm. But he never really actually explained to them his rules, even though he took the time to explain it to the audience.
Right.
We spend a lot of time with him in the beginning, and then he's on one of the major highways, like an interstate, trying to get to Columbus, Ohio, because that's where his family is, even though he doesn't have a really good relationship with anyone. He makes it abundantly clear that he's a bit of a loner, and he doesn't have a girlfriend, he doesn't have too many friends, pretty much none at all. He just spent all his time at home playing World of Warcraft.
Right.
Mountain Dew Code Red.
I was addicted to that shit for a while.
Oh, what am I gonna do? I'm addicted to Mountain Dew!
This is excellent.
Yeah.
Baja Blast is still far superior.
Oh, Baja Blast. Yeah, I love Baja Blast.
Yes.
enough with the advertising. Dude, because they're not a sponsor of the Hardcast yet. And then he's wandering on the interstate, and then this is when he runs into the next character, Tallahassee, who's driving in an Escalade.